Using FireMonkey as a game engine. Hello, today I'll speak about FireMonkey and how to use it for game coding. We'll see a lot of topics. I'm Patrick Premartin, MVP Embarcadero. I'm freelance Delphi and web developer since 2000. Delphi user since the beginning and before with Borland and Turbo Pascal. And I'm a game coder since a little more. If you know the TO770, you'll know what I mean. Something like 1983 or 4. I have a lot of websites, but if you want to contact me, you can follow me on GitHub, itch.io for games, Twitch, where I have a channel, live coding channel and game coding, my blog developer-pascal.fr, or LinkedIn. What's a game engine? A game engine is a library or a set of components available to create games. You have code, SDK, and sometimes editor tools, or you can use external tools like Tilde for map editing and Sense. A game engine is not a complete game making software like you have in with Game Maker Studio and a lot of other game creating software. There are a lot of game making software and game engines coded in Pascal. You probably know Castle Game Engine. Michelis Camburelis will talk about it, and it's a new Delphi compatibility in the DelphiCon 2021. You can look at it in the scheduler. You perhaps heard about some of these other game engines for Delphi or Pascal developers. Gorilla 3D Framework, Appus Game Engine, with some presentations on YouTube, SDL2, and a lot of others, more or less abandoned. FireMonkey is a multi-platform set of components and libraries available in Delphi. You have VCL for Windows projects since Delphi 1, and since Delphi XE2, we have FireMonkey for all mature platforms. In the last release, Delphi 11 Alexandria, you can target Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, and Android platforms depending on your license level. The idea behind FireMonkey is to have one project and one source code to target all major platforms. You don't need to know platform languages like Objective-C, Swift, Java, and others. FireMonkey includes classic visual components, but also shapes, animations, visual effects, 3D, access to system API, and other libraries. It's included in all Delphi license level, even the community edition, free for personal use, and academic edition. Why using FireMonkey to code games? The simpler answer could be why not, and in fact, it's the first reason I had to play with it. Second answer is more technical. FireMonkey draws everything on screen by default. Visual components are sets of shapes and effects. They are styled and can be changed without coding. We have 3D and 2D components and layers in standard. Touch, mouse, keyboard are managed by Delphi. It works for classic programs, so it works for games too. We can use properties and events, timers and threads, multi-resolution images and bitmaps, classes and all things needed to code games. Is there really games in Delphi and FMX in the world? Yes. In 2021, I streamed weekly game coding sessions on Twitch with Delphi and FireMonkey. Published games are available at gamolf.itch.io. Some projects have been open sourced on my GitHub account, github.com/ Developer Pascal and the repository is dev pass minus games minus pack. A lot of other projects are available with the Delphi game hashtag in GitHub. You have the links if you want download the PDF of the slides after the presentation. You can also check the showcase part of Embarcadero blogs at blogs.embarcadero.com and choose showcase like I'll do. So you have a lot of apps, Android, iOS, and others, and some of them are games. Monkey is a good solution to compile on multi-platforms. And there are more on iOS and Android stores. If you want a list for Delphi apps on Android, you can look at Little Zerch, com.embarcadero games at play.google.com, and you'll find all games and apps coded in the Delphi or C++ builder. Apps which developers didn't change the option project information. So we have com.embarcadero in their package name. Like that. Yep. Autocode game with FireMonkey. You have a lot of samples on GitHub, on my account and other accounts. We'll see some topics of game coding with sample. First of all, managing music and sound effects. For music and sounds in Delphi, we have T-Media Player, non-visual component. It plays MP3 music, WAV files, and other formats depending on the platform. I use it for background music on games and sound effects with WAV file. I published a little library you can use it for your games if you want. It's on the this one. It's on this repository, Delphi FMX Game Snippets on GitHub. I'll show you. Donc, in this repository, we have a lot of samples of animations and other things you can do with FireMonkey easily for game development. And for music, you have three projects. This one. It's better I open the free, yes, ajouter, existant. This one. And this. Each button plays a sound with the same library here. you have to create a class, an instance of tmusicloop, and load the sound, play it when you need. Of course, the load is only needed the first time you click the button, or you want to play the sound. For background music, we have this project. This program, you can play a music with loop. So let's look at the code. Here we have the choice of the file, and we start the playing with the music loop variable. The play button use only play if the music is not playing. The stop button stops the music when it's playing. Very simple. Music loop is a tdata module with a tmedia player and a timer. We can change the volume, load a file, MP3 or other formats, play a file with a loop or without a loop, or play the current file with a loop or without a loop. We can play sound. Play sound is only for effects. It stopped after the end of the sound. Stop is stopping the current music. And you can test if it's playing or it's active. If it's not active, you don't have a music or a file loaded in the library. You can use this in your games if you want. And other tests, this one. Hop. With this one, we can change the sound and volume. You can copy this in your games if you want to manage sound volume, activate or enable or disable it. In the source, it's simple to a switch, two switch, with the play stop in it. The same for the other. And the sound is changed directly to the volume in the library. One for music, one for sound. the music loop objects, and this is the data module. It's all for music, so you can use it on your games if you want. Some sample, yes, I have it. Backgrounds and scenes. I use images for this and shapes because we have des rectangles and des circles which can be used with their backgrounds. They have a bitmap in the fill property. We can use it without using the image list directly on them. And we can draw on it if you want. Well, FireMonkey visual components are containers. They can be parents for all other visual components. All visual components have opacity, rotation, scale properties. We can use non-visual components to change property values in a specific direction. T-float animation is very useful. We have visual effects as non-visual components like shadow and glow effects. We can use them for games and classic programs to show errors or needed edit files. It gives us unlimited possibilities without coding anything, and of course we can code. For the game Egg Hunter, available at gamewolf.itch.io, I need to manage sprite positions and action in different threads. I wanted 60 FPS frame per second. I didn't check if I succeeded, but the result is good enough in terms of user experience. I'll show you there. You see no problem of drawing. And it's speed enough to play as we want. For this game, I use the T-image as the only image in the form. You have only one form, the main form, and an image. All drawing, all sprites are on a bitmap. I manage in threads, in background. The bitmap change when I change the viewport position. and sprite action, of course. A timer check every 16 milliseconds if I change the buffer bitmap. If so, I copy it to the same bitmap. So to the principal image. It's simple, just need some booleans and temutex to avoid access violation, conflicts and sprite flipping. One of the problems in this game is the duck's movement. I remove them from a case, from a cell, sorry, and I display them on another cell. The image has to be drawn only when the two operations are done. I use mutex to stop it and free it, like Begin Sen and Sen in Fire Monkey. Egg Hunter, here. Yes, alors, the game is here. There. It's a map, an image, and a timer. The timer check if the buffer is changed. If so, I get a pointer to the buffer, at a bitmap. I'll check if it's okay, of course. If the size of the buffer is the same of the image in the screen, because we can have resize of window, or on mobile you can change orientation, so the size width and height can be exchanged. So I copy the buffer only if the size is the same. And I copy the buffer when needed. And to draw the buffer, it's simple. I have a global refresh send buffer method. Which is a viewport change or size change. I draw the entire map, the entire viewport, enfin map in the viewport, cell by cell with this. So I acquire the mutex and release it after that. And for each cell of the map, I do the same if needed, and I draw the content. And to draw the content, I use directly the canvas of the tbit map from my buffer with a begin scene and end scene, and drawing on it. I empty it, and I have 10 z index. Bitmaps, I draw with draw bitmap and not a copy from a bitmap because I need some sprite transparency. So if I use a copy from bitmap, only the last one is displayed. Draw bitmap is drawing all images, taking care of the alpha color. In other games, I use a simple layout to simulate the Z-index or to use it as forms. You have samples in this depot. Here, ici, hop. Animations, météo, weather. Here I have snow and ducks in a different z-index. And I change the window orientation. So some snow is behind or above ducks. I have a more visible sample here. Back, 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 canard. Ouais, ici. I have three layouts as rectangle and their fill. And their fill property is a bitmap property with an image. The same image for all of them. I have an animation on each about position.x, so horizontal position. With loop, yes, loop and auto reverse value. So the image go to right and to left and to right and to left with no code. And I added some ducks on the screen here. And you see what is done. So I have a different Z index because I have ducks between between layouts. And before them. I use it in the game. OK Ducky. Let me show you. I cut the music because YouTube don't like it. some DMCA in it. So we have the ducks in the free couch, free layer. And the all images are on their layout. So in this sample, here create. The idea is to have a free layout and ducks with one layout as parent or another. Here, I create a duck. I choose with a random the layout where I put it. As parent, and the duck move. No, not many code to do that. Hein. For user interface, it's simple too. I can use still visual components, shapes or images. For text, I use tlabel if I want the look and feel of the operating system, or ttext when I prefer to change the color, size, font and other style. For buttons, I use tbutton, personal style button, or I draw them in a frame with the rectangle, images, effects, and text. It's what I did for Egg Hunter. Là, ici. Here I have a frame with the dialog box here. It's a simple rectangle with the background. And I have the scroll box. Not directly on the rectangle, but in the same level. The reason is I can change opacity of the background without changing the opacity of the content. And when I use it, also in the main form, here, I have the frame with its background, and in the content scroll box, I have buttons, and my buttons are frames too. My buttons are here. Button, button, button. Where are you? Where are you? Sorry, yeah. My button is here, and it's a frame with two rectangles. The first one is the rectangle when the button is not checked, is not active, and the second one when the button is active. So I have an effect when I click or if I move the mouse on it. Under each rectangle I have the text, the same for the two. In my code, I use mouse down on the frame, mouse leave and mouse up on the frame. When the mouse is down, when we click, I activate the button. When the mouse leaves the frame, I unactive it. And the same when I release the click button of the mouse. Here. Activating the frame is changing the rectangle I show. And copying the text from the second rectangle to the first one, or from the first one, depending on what text I feel when I use the button. Result is here. When I click, I have the image. It changes. And of course, I can change the background of each button if I want. It's only pictures. You can look at CodeRage 2018 presentation I did with Christmas game, a simple game of a clicking game. The source is on GitHub too. There, Christmas game and Delphi. Same thing for this game. I have some frames. As buttons or as sprites. and the main frame with layout, and I use layout for screens. I activate, I show and hide layouts depending of the screen I want to show. This one is probably save score, game over, here. There, I want the option screen. Hall of Fame, and so on. All graphics are frames, and I use them as any components in the code. I use animations with sprite sheets. My button is only a rectangle for the background and the text above. For sprite, yes, here. I have a rectangle for the sprite and an animation. This animation is a T bitmap list animation with a bitmap. Where is it? Ici. With an explosion sprite sheet. The only thing I need to do when I when the bomb explodes is to activate the animation. And the code is simple. For sprites, I use bitmaps and the fill property for rectangle and t-circle. For the visual elements, I use t-images and image lists, or the background of other shapes, depending on the form of the sprite. For animation, I use t-bitmap list animation if I have a sprite sheet, or I do it with a timer. I change the bitmap depending on what I want on the sprite. You have another sample in the same repository, an explosion and a moving ninja, if I remember the project. So here, explosion. So I have a duck and an animation on the duck with a bitmap. And here is my app. So my program is here. I activated the transparent property of the form by ID in this case, but you can look at it when I start the program. I activate the transparency and the if I click outside any component or behind the sprite, I'm outside the form. So in FireMonkey, we can manage forms with pictures directly on it. You just have to change the transparency property of the form And for the explode canard, I activate the animation I put on it. Other sample with the sprite. The sprite is here. It's an image with an animation for the jump and some sprite on it, but only way. Not many sprites, only four. Animation for the position. The déplacement is automatic and the walking animation. With a sprite too. Sprite sheet too. It's on the layout. We have a rectangle for the bottom of the form and a button here. When I want to jump, I stop the walking animation. I change the Y position and I activate the jump animation. In the jump animation, I process the position depending of the duration. And when it's finished, I stop the jump, I activate the walk, and I restore the position. It's very simple. For collisions, it's simple because Delphi does it since the first release with a mouse click. We can check them because we have coordinates for each component on the screen. Intersect rect is a very useful and unknown method to check if two rectangles collide. For circles, I calculate the distance between center of each circle and compare it to the sum of their radius. I have a sample too in this repository and the good screen here. Bubbles, 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 this one. I use the circles and two timers. One timer to create new circles on the screen, the second one to move the circles. When two circles touch them, each other, I remove them. The generator is only a create circle with coordinates on the screen. The other timer move all circles. And check if they go outside the screen. And in it, I check collisions between two circles. So I have a loop. For each circle, I check all others with a method here. And it's only maths. It's the base for another game. here, soap bubbles, where it changes the circles with images. And they don't disappear when they touch each other. They are bigger and sometimes they are too big. To win, we have to click on each bubble before they explode. Of course, it's easier when they are bigger. And the click is only hit test and on click from Delphi. Standard behavior. In FireMonkey and VCL. For a circle versus rectangle, I calculate the distance between the circle center and each angle of the rectangle. The classic samples for this is Pong or Breakout game, when the ball hits a wall or a brick. You have a sample too. I did it for Learn to Code Summer Camp 2021 and it's in the GitHub repository with games. So here, game pack, breakout et this one. So I move the paddle with the keyboard and the ball is a T-circle with an image. Bricks are rectangles with a background. So, yes, here. Yeah. So the screen has a timer to move the ball, the button to play, a rectangle for the background, and in it, the game zone. Another rectangle with a background, black background. The ball is not a circle like I said, but a rectangle. And the paddle too. But the paddle has a radius to show it with round corners. So collide, here. For the collisions, I test so with intersects. Ok. Ball is a rectangle, brick. Bricks are rectangles too. So I can check the bounds of the two. What about FreeDay? FireMonkey as 3D components and we can do 3D, 3D games with it. Grégory Berseger, French Embarcadero MVP, has a lot of games in his GitHub account. You can check them. I'll show you this free. Friday Pong Project. I don't remember how to play. Oh yes, with the mouse. So it's 3D components on a viewport in a classic form. You have the material source for the lights, the rectangle. Inside it, a viewport 3D where you can put the 3D components. The light, a layout with text here. And the ball. Where is the ball? Racket. One player, the other one. Is, I don't remember where. Celui-là. Base, bord. The ball. Oh, I suppose he creates the computer player by code. Don't remember. You can check the code et puis and ask him a question if you want. Other sample FMX Corridor. It's a remake of an old Atari game. Here. My computer is a little has little problems. I'm in a VM, virtual machine. Sometimes it has speed problems, and here is one. So, bad sample for a live session. And the last one, an island pour un FPG FPS, first personnel shooter if you want that. Same problem with speed because of my computer. I can't change it. Did I say it's simple to use Delphi and FireMonkey for game coding and deploying them for Windows game, Mac, Linux, iOS and Android device? With the samples and links, I hope you have all what you need to understand how to use FireMonkey as a game engine in your games and how to use game techniques in other programs. If not, you can contact me and tell me what is missing, or submit new feature requests directly in Embarcadero Quality Portal. quality.embarcadero.com. Sorry, I'm not live for Q&A during the DelphiCon 2021, but if you want to talk, leave me a message on LinkedIn or at developer.pascal.fr contact. You also can talk with me on Twitch during a live game coding or live coding for other things. You have my channel, and you can write in French or English. But as you see, my English is poor when I speak. Writing is better for me. If you need translating, you can use deepl.com. Thanks for watching, and enjoy the DelphiCon.